What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you notice anything different, I am hands-free today because, baby, I got my ring light and my tripod in. I am so excited. I feel legit. I got a little light in this background. This kitchen looks much brighter than it would if I just had that light on. But things are moving fast, and I'm excited. Before we get into it, make sure that you press that subscribe button. Make sure that you hit the like button after this video, and then also leave a comment. Let me know what you want to see me cook, try out for the first time, anything. I am here to take suggestions and continue down this food journey with you. Okay, doing too much. Let's get to the cooking. So, what is on the menu for tonight? Tonight we're gonna be cooking salmon. We're gonna start with the meat side down, get it brown on the bottom. Then we're gonna transfer it into a pan, put it in the oven and get a nice crisp for the skin. For our vegetable, we have bok choy. I've never cooked bok choy before, but we're gonna steam it. And then, you know, add some salt, pepper for flavor. And then we have rice as our base. It's just gonna be a simple white rice as a base. But to top this off, we're gonna be making a honey-based sauce. And for that, the ingredients will be the honey, lemon, garlic, soy sauce, and oyster sauce. I've never tried this before, so it's just gonna be a taste and test and go and see what works out. But in terms of our dry ingredients, we do have garlic powder, onion powder, black pepper, pink Himalayan sea salt, and then of course our olive oil. Let's get started. Okay, let's get started. But first off, check out my little remote that goes to this tripod. It can start and stop my videos. I'm psyched. Okay, anyways, so how we're gonna start with this bok choy. The lady on YouTube said, cut it down the middle. From there, we're gonna do a quick clean. Just get in there, remove any excess debris. Okay, so from here, if you did get the larger bok choy, we have to cut out this root part right here because it's not edible, so we're gonna go ahead and do that. I would recommend, hold on. I would recommend getting the baby bok choy. When I went to see how to cook this, everyone used the baby bok choy because it's much easier and you can eat the whole thing. It's simpler, but we got this. So we're gonna go ahead and cut the root out. Just gonna do an angle cut. Boom, done, toss it. Now, what I'm gonna do is go back and individually wash these because they still got dirt in there. Jeez, calm down. Yeah, I'm just gonna break these off. Wash them up. Down the middle. This one has a little more of the root left on it. I'm just gonna cut the bottom off. Look, that's what we're gonna do. When in doubt, cut the whole thing off. That's what friends, that's what family, when in doubt, cut the whole thing off. Your boss, cut the whole thing off. Co-workers who are new with you, cut the whole thing off. Mm-mm. 2019 and beyond, we just cutting the whole thing off. It ain't working. It's not me, it's you. I am so stupid. Okay. Shake those off. Oh, damn. Broke it. Okay, so I don't know how much this is going to be. But I'm just gonna put this whole thing into, I don't know if I need both of these. They may shrink, they may not shrink, but I'm just gonna start with one and go from there. Let me see if this will fit first. I'm gonna improvise. You know what? Yeah, I'm gonna improvise. The big ones, I'm just gonna cut it like that. We're still gonna eat this part, but I'm gonna focus mostly on this. No, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna focus on this. Forget the bottom half. I'm still gonna cook it. I'm just gonna cut it so that it all fits. Just keep it simple. And I'm actually gonna cut this other half too. Shine bright like a diamond. So we're gonna use the Instant Pot to steam these. This is the little basket it came with. I wanna get a smaller one because of these holes, but whatever, this is what we have. Put that in there. First off, you wanna fill the bottom of this with some water as well. So that it creates that steam. And now you wanna put these in. What I'm also gonna do, I wanna take these back out, spread them across this board, and you can leave some in here. But take your pink Himalayan sea salt, the black pepper, just season these up. Okay, you can smash them in. They're gonna steam up, they're gonna shrink, so we're good with that. I'm gonna take a break and clean up, and I'll be right back. Didn't work. Okay, next up, we have our salmon. We're gonna unpack this. Get this unpacked. Get your plate so you can season it. Let's dump some of this juice off. So, basic seasonings. Hit it with the pepper. Pink Himalayan sea salt. Okay, that's good. Garlic powder per usual. And then the onion powder. Okay, so for this, we are going to also, let's see. We got our pan over here. Just gonna put a little bit of olive oil on the bottom of the pan. Just enough so that it doesn't stick. This is a non-stick pan, so we should be good. Bam! Bam! Thank you, ma'am. That's what I'm talking about. We hands free out here. I don't think y'all know how excited I am about this tripod. Like, it's about to go down. Like, yo, I have the vision. We got a whole kitchen up in here. But also, let's put our oven on a cool 300 degrees. 300 degrees to start. Because after we cook the meat side on this pan, we're going to switch it over to this and then put it into the oven. I think that should be good. Okay. So, skin side down, skin side down, or skin side up. We essentially just want to get the bottom a brown color, a golden brown. Also, we noticed we didn't season it while it was on this plate. Because we can now season the skin since we're just gonna transfer it right into this pan. Okay, so this is what you want it to look like on the bottom. Nice golden brown, set that in to your pan. Matter of fact, I mean, it should be good. We don't need any more oil. Woo! That's what you want. Let me put it down before I break it. That is what you want. That's what we came for. That's all we wanted. It's still pink on the sides, but it's set on the bottom. We're just gonna toss this into the oven. Put this on the top rack because how we're gonna make the skin crispy is we're gonna broil it, but it's gonna be very quick. If you leave it too long, it's gonna burn. But don't worry about that yet. The fish still has to cook through, which is why we're putting it into the oven. Turn this down. And actually, I forgot to turn on the bok choy, so I'm gonna turn that on. I'm gonna let this cook. And I'll be back. Okay, for this part, it's very simple, very basic. I have some white rice. If you don't know how to cook white rice, then you know what? I don't know what to do. But this is 2 cups of rice. We're gonna pour it in. It says add 2.5 cups of water for 2 cups of rice. Bring it to a hard boil. Let that boil go for 1 minute. From there, turn it down and let it simmer for 20 minutes with the lid on. After that, I think you're gonna remove the lid, turn the fire off, and let it sit for 10 minutes, but we ain't gonna do all that. When it looks done to me, that's when it'll be done. Okay! Bring it up to a boil. Let it boil for a minute, then turn it down, put your lid on, let it cook. We'll be back. Also got this little baby pan for our honey sauce later. Okay, we're back and I'm sweating, but that's okay. Look at this light. Look at that ring light. Just want to do a check-in on the fish. I don't want it to be dry, so let's take a look. This light might be a little too bright. You see how it's still a bit of pink towards the top of the fish? That's how you want it. Because we're still going to broil this, so... Once it has that light pink on the towards the top, you put it back in and you're gonna put this on a broil and let it go. Watch this closely. I'm putting it on low because if it was on high, if you miss a beat, like 10 seconds, that thing will be crispy. So make sure you put it on the low broil, let it take its time and keep checking on it like every 30 seconds or so. You'll see it start to get brown, and when you get it to as brown and crispy as you want it, cut it off, period. Okay, I'll be back when it's done. Welcome back. The fish is officially done. Let's take a look. Boom. Boom. Oh shit, you see that? And this is what I mean, if you take your eye off it for a second, that thing might burn. But fish is done, the skin is crisp, the bottom is brown, we're gonna leave that in there, turn the oven off, but just close it so it'll keep the fish warm. Let's take a look. I don't know what they were talking about with this rice, because that shit is done. That was all of like 5 minutes. I don't know what they're talking about, 20 minutes and all that. And then our bok choy. Bok choy, nice and steamy. With that, I'm gonna add some more like salt and pepper to it, just because. It looks a little bland. We just gonna go back to the basics. So with this, get you a little knife. With these, we're just going, holy shit. Well, that flew right out the skin, right out the skin. You don't want to do that, but, something close to it. So this garlic is going to be for our sauce. Everything else is pretty much done.
I like garlic a lot. So you choose how much garlic you use, but I'm about to use the whole kitchen of garlic. Get a little bowl. And then just start chopping this up. Oh, that's a lot of garlic. That's a lot of garlic. We ain't gonna use all that garlic. Jesus. I went a little overboard. You wanna roll your lemon and get the juices going? Get the juices going. Actually, I think we are just going to use all this. And whatever we don't use, we'll just save it for later. Cut your lemon. And you want to go in and just pick your little seeds out. Shouldn't be that hard. Okay, got your lemon and garlic juice.
You know what? I kind of messed up. I shouldn't have put that lemon juice into the garlic just yet because I wanted the garlic to cook first. But it already happened, so we gotta keep going. As you watch this, make sure you cook the garlic first and then add the lemon juice. Okay, I'm gonna let that cook for a little. I definitely should have let this cook first. But we'll see. Let's turn it down. Let's turn it down because we're gonna start adding our honey. And you don't want the honey to burn. You want to add just a touch of the oyster sauce. Mmm. Ooh. Oh, turn it down. It's bubbling up. Turn it down. We're about to make some molasses up in this bitch. Let's see. I told you this is my first time cooking this, so I'm tasting and trying. I like it. It's a bit lemony, which is not a bad thing. I'm gonna toss just a couple dashes of soy sauce and then some more of the honey. And I think that might be it. Mix it up. Turn it up a little. Turn it back down. It's beautiful. I'm kind of doing this backward. Oh, shit. Wait. Let me switch hands. Turn it up a little. I think that's it. Let me do one last taste. One last taste. Mmm. Ooh. Baby girl. I'm putting this sauce into a bottle tomorrow. Who wanna distribute this shit? Ooh. Mmm. That's nice. That is nice. Look, I just made that from scratch, out of nothing. Thin air, poof. I'll be back. Boom. There you have it, guys. I just put a bed of rice down the middle, put the salmon on top of that, threw the bok choy on the side, and then drizzled the sauce on it. And that's it. That's that on that. In terms of the price, altogether it was about $18. The salmon was $9, the bok choy is about $6, and then the rice is a big bag. I just rounded it to like $1 or $2, but $18 total. Each of these come out to 4 dishes, so whether you want to eat it salmon, bok choy, and rice for dinner 4 nights in a row, or if you want to take lunch, dinner for 2 days, it's up to you. But always remember that it's cheaper to eat at home, it's easy, it's quick, and you'll love it. You'll know what's in it. You know it's healthy. But thank you for tuning in. Be sure to come back every Tuesday and Friday for another video. Also, if you haven't already, subscribe. Wait, what's that? Subscribe. Also, like and comment. Let me know what you want to see next for me to cook, even if it's a dish that I haven't tried before. This is what this channel is for. But as always, love you guys and keep it cooking.